Buongiorno, fabulous people. It is March 5th, 2020, and no, I haven't turned into zombie yet, unless I'm just not aware of it. But today I really wanted to give you a live update of what is happening in Italy and specifically in my beloved Rome. I cannot tell you for how long I've been going back and forth about making this video, but when I saw how much media blew this thing out of proportion, when I read the news that been coming my way 24/7, when I received so many insane, bizarre questions from people from all over the world regarding Italy, regarding Rome, I just felt like it is my responsibility as an expat living in Rome to give you guys a live update and to tell you what is really happening here. No, I am not going to share with you any medical records or numbers. I am not a doctor, so what I will share with you in this video is a live update of what is happening on the streets of Rome, all over the Eternal City, of what I hear, of what the mood is of the people in Italy. This is going to be an honest, straight to the point update of what is really happening in the Eternal City. So this is what is really happening in Rome. All the major sites, they are still open. All the cafes, shops, restaurants, metro, taxi, everything is operating as normal. Yes. And if you go into our grocery stores, you will still find meats and cheeses and milk and toilet paper on the shelves. No, guys, Romans are not sitting inside terrified watching the news 24/7 and wearing masks. Romans are outside going to work as always every single day, going out enjoying the stunning beautiful weather that we have in our city, because pretty much the spring is here and it's been here ever since February. They're still going for the walks, they're still doing their passeggiata, they're still going out to the restaurants enjoying pasta carbonara and amatriciana with a glass of wine, they're still meeting with their friends and family, and the daily life in Rome is continued as normal. The only major change that did happen is that as of today, until March 15th, all the schools, all the universities will be closed, and all the major events like soccer matches and concerts will be cancelled. These extreme measures have been placed by the Italian government, of course, first and foremost to protect its elderly people, as well as the people with compromised immune system, but also because this overblown press created hysteria, created huge economic problems for Italy, and Italy is feeling it on a daily basis. Every day that is passing by is bringing Italy closer and closer and closer to the economic crisis. And this is something that is very, very serious. And this is something that media does not care about. It's all about creating those big headline news. It's all about exaggerating, creating emergency. Media should not be reporting on medical cases. Doctors, scientists should be commenting on coronavirus, but not media. They're not trained to report on medical emergencies. What they're trained on is to make it viral, to make it sensational, to provoke some kind of emotions out of you. And what emotion sells more news than fear? And if we're really so concerned about diseases all over the world and in the United States, why are we then not talking about 24 million cases of flu-like illnesses, 180,000 hospitalizations, 16,000 dead from influenza? Why are we talking about the coronavirus so much, guys? Like we have no other disease on this planet. What I really like about this entire thing is the undefeated spirit of the Italian people. Italians, you are incredible. You are so positive throughout this entire situation, you showed me your undefeated spirit and the sense of positivity that I've never seen from a nation before. With everything that is happening, you're still enjoying your dolce vita, you're still singing songs outside, you're still out and about enjoying your passeggiadas, going out, meeting with friends and families. You are incredible, guys. You will get through this. We will get through this. I'm with you, Italy. I'm not leaving. I'm going to be here until we will get this thing defeated. And I just wanted to express to you my infinite love and infinite admiration for this country and for this beautiful, incredible nation. And I'm so proud to call Italy my home. And I will be proud to call this my home for the rest of my life. And to my fellow Americans, I did not make this video to convince you to come here. I only made this video to show you the reality of the situation in Italy and of course in Rome specifically. I wanted to show you that Italy is living its daily life as usual. All the major sites, shops, restaurants, cafes, metro, everything is open and operating as normal. The weather is absolutely stunning. Blue skies, bright sunshine, everything is blooming. And the Eternal City is as breathtaking as always. But most importantly, guys, we're all waiting for you here. Of course, whenever you decide to come. And whether it's going to be your first time in this stunning, one-of-a-kind country, or you make Italy your yearly destination, this country cannot wait to welcome you and to host you. I'm sending you lots of love from the Eternal City.